Some of you might recognize this book. I did a video with it like 2 years ago. And there were a couple of people who asked me to keep going with it, and I said I would, and then I kind of forgot about it. So today we're gonna jump back into it. This is obviously Night Vision, Magical Photographs of Life After Dark. It's really pretty. We didn't get that far into it. I went back and checked the video. We made it to like page 40. So we're gonna just jump back in there. I don't know. I hope this is in frame for you guys. The way I have my setup right now, it's a little, I can't see my screen on my phone, so. Park ride of some kind, probably not. this is not how I look on rides. I love rides, roller coasters and whatnot. But when I'm, maybe this is in the middle, but in the beginning, no matter how many times I've rode the ride that day or in the past, I always get so extremely nervous and anxious. So I never look happy until the ride has actually started. And if it's a roller coaster, I don't look happy until we've gotten to the top of the hill, because I think the climb of the hill is the absolute, like, worst thing. So, that was from Munich, Germany. Riders enjoy an amusement park thrill during Oktoberfest. This is beautiful, my goodness. Oh goodness. I don't know how to say that. It's a province in Thailand. Fire and spinning steel wool create a fountain of light in a rock canyon. That's gorgeous. Oh my goodness. Wow. It almost doesn't look real. The way it, like, cascades over the rocks when it lands. The circle in the middle, this almost kind of gives me, Doctor Strange, you know, and Wong, their little vortex magic thing they do. That kind of reminds me of that, actually. But it's very, very simple. Looks like this place would be beautiful on its own with these rock faces and the water. Hong Kong performers wait to begin the Cathay Pacific International Chinese New Year Night Parade. They National Park. Wispy mists from hot springs take on a blue hue under a starry night. Oh my gosh, that sounds amazing. Oh my god. Stunning. What the fuck? I really want to go to Yellowstone. Obviously, it's beautiful, but this is something else. When I really want to go to some of the national parks for stargazing alone, because they don't have the kind of light pollution that we do, and you can see so much more of the Milky Way. This is something else though, like truly, truly very beautiful. A young boy runs across an interactive light display created by a couple people in the fashion design label Depression at the Singapore Night Festival. Again, this almost doesn't look real. It almost looks like a video game or a movie or something. Very psychedelic. Tree. This and some like rocks, like bigger rocks, like this is quite thesaurus or so I can get some more words to use. Wow. Dubai, United Arab Emirates. Goodness, I hate to butcher words in other languages. It's a hotel. It appears like a sail in the middle of a lightning storm. Scary. I mean, I wouldn't want to be struck by lightning, but I just find it fascinating. I've always loved thunderstorms. Like, I listen to thunderstorms to go to sleep sometimes, or a lot of times. And I always loved to play in the rain as a kid. And here, and I'm sure in a lot of other places, in the summer especially, because when it's so hot, we get a lot of heat lightning. And I used to love to go lay outside on the grass and watch heat lightning storms at night. So this is really, really nice. Especially with the kind of green color theme we have going on the side of this little hotel. Maybe wouldn't want to be up here during this. Twirl on red ribbons as they entertain nightclub patrons. If it wasn't for like the phones and the subtle showings of technology, the coloring on this and the way they're in the air, it almost looks like you know, like an old painting that would be on like church ceilings and stuff. Such amazing feats of talent and hard work shown here. I would love to see this, but I feel like I would be a little nervous for one of them to fall onto the crowd and for somebody to get really hurt. I know they train really hard and they're professionals, but things do happen. Accidents can happen still, so I think that would make me a little nervous. See a show like this, like Cirque du Soleil or something. Or, you know, just go to a Pink concert, because apparently she's doing shit like this all the time. Pine Ridge Indian Reservation in South Dakota. Traditional dancers perform at an Oglala Lakota Nation powwow night. Truly important becomes whole and sound again. Antoine de Saint, your guess is as good as mine. But this is lovely. I find a lot of Native American culture extremely fascinating, and also sad that they've been stripped of so much of it. Or oppressed into not being able to celebrate it the way that maybe they'd like, or on the scale that they'd like. Are from New South Wales, Australia, a wave curls back into the dark ocean. Okay, Little Mermaid vibes. This is beautiful. And like, what were you doing out there that you caught this photo, like, with your expensive camera just in the middle of the ocean? Lights illuminate shipping containers at the port of Singapore. And honestly, who would think that something as benign as shipping containers could actually be quite lovely with the cityscape as their backdrop and the colors and the lights. I like that this picture and that this book includes them. That are maybe more mundane because there's a lot of beauty to be found in day-to-day life and not just in things that are extraordinary. And so I really like this one a lot, actually. Switzerland. As the lights of the city stretch below, a skier takes to the air. Yeah, that's quite frightening looking, but... Oh, sorry, guys. Much respect to skiers and snowboarders because it takes a lot of skills that I will never have, and a lot of bravery that I will never have. Shine on the stalactites, oh my god, can I read? No, apparently I cannot. So a cave, rock formations basically. Oh my god, I wish I could bump one more thing too for you guys. Obviously the lights are adding some ambiance to this, but I'm sure the cave is quite beautiful in and of itself. British Columbia, Canada, looking for prey, a female barred owl swoops through a forest. This is quite majestic. Owls are so kind of mysterious and like they have a grace to them, don't they? Like this is very, I don't know. Stop here because we got a nice little quote and a nice picture before, and we can pick this back up later if you guys would like. This says, "Oh, radiant dark, oh, darkly fostered ray. Thou hast a joy too deep for shallow day. From George Eliot. And this is from Chiang Mai, Thailand. Monks release a lantern to join the hundreds of others dotting the sky during a festival. They look happy. And this is fucking incredible. I've always wanted to go to a lantern festival. Just so beautiful, especially like I know some, this doesn't seem to be one, but I know some like you, like they will draw on their lanterns, like not really sure if it's like wishes or hopes or dreams, whatever, but I don't know, it just seems like a good time and obviously very beautiful. Want me to keep going, please do just let me know. But if you guys get